This video is going to be a three-part video, I believe, about the months-long restoration process of my Pioneer RT909 reel-to-reel deck. This video contains some footage that was shot over a year ago, and the project was recently picked up about 3 months ago. And I continued working on it until last weekend, and now I've got to edit the video together. But goes through basically a full process of restoration. As I mentioned in the end of the video, the only thing I haven't done with it yet is get the heads relapped, and they do have some wear. They will need it at some point, although the high frequencies have not dropped off as of yet. So with that, let's get to the video. What's wrong with this one is I've actually started doing a little bit of pre-work on this, but what's wrong with this one is the pinch rollers have essentially disintegrated. The rubber is so sticky and gooey. I got them in a bag here just so I don't have to get everything dirty touching them. But the pinch rollers have disintegrated and are next to useless. And then also the capstan belt, as you can see, does not actually wind around all of where it should. It's sort of stuck to the flywheels here. And that'll probably require some cleaning as well. So the capstan belt's no good, and the pinch rollers are no good. I think that's pretty common with these models. I don't know what was up with the rubber that was used originally, although it is 30 to 35 years later here. So either way, the rubber is probably no good. But what I'm going to be doing basically is trying to get this deck working just to figure out if there's any other problems with it. So I've actually ordered a kit that contains a brand new capstan belt, which is nice, and then two brand new pinch rollers here, and the rubber is very nice. I can see it also includes some washers and stuff to go with them, so that's nice. So right now the task of the moment is taking out the old capstan belt, the motor, and cleaning up those flywheels, and then going from there to replace the new belt and put on the new pinch rollers and get everything cleaned up and give it a shot. Well, I've got the thing apart. I've got my flywheels out, and I'm currently working on trying to clean off the rubber goo that's on these. As you can see, I've been scraping and wiping it on this paper towel. It's just complete goo. It almost looked like a solid piece of belt to me. See, like this one. It looks like a solid piece of belt. You could just, maybe it's stuck on there or something. No, it's all goo, which I've heard a lot about this, so it wasn't completely unexpected. There's also goo on the capstan motor, and to top that all off, there's some stuck piece of something there too I gotta clean off. So I'm gonna probably spend a while here. The Goo Gone, I've used on this similar kind of situation in the past, and it seemed to work quite well. To really polish up the surface and get rid of any of the stickiness, and then let it dry really well before I put a new belt on there, obviously. Probably rinse with water before I put the belt in, just to make sure there's no traces of Goo Gone in there. I don't want any chemicals in there with the rubber now. It's supposed to be dry, and I don't want any residue or anything else, because I've heard that can deteriorate rubber quite quickly again. And I don't want to go back and have the same thing happen in a year or so. So I got to make sure it's perfectly dry and clean, and then I'll go ahead and reassemble it. Well, I've got the new capstan belt installed there. Everything's cleaned up really nice and put away, so motor's all put back in and mounted correctly. And the next step is going to be to clean up the nasty old pinch rollers in order to get those little covers off of them, because I need to reuse those for the new pinch rollers and then install them on the deck. So everything's cleaned up on the deck. I have the faceplate off so I can access some of the screws a little better, and it's just a little bit easier at the moment. But I'm gonna get those little covers and try and clean things off. That way I can install the new pinch rollers on the deck. Well, I've got the new pinch rollers installed. Everything's cleaned up real nice. And I think it's time to see if this deck will actually play a tape or not, because before I couldn't even try. So let's load it up and see if it'll play a tape. Let's turn it on here. Yeah, you can see the display's there, and then I've been told this thing is pretty easy to thread. I watched a video online on YouTube of somebody threading this thing. It looked like it was pretty simple here. Just let's see. And then let's play. I think I might have to adjust the tension over here a little bit, but that's no big deal as long as it's working. Changes the meters thing. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit. Well, it seems to be working. Let's see. Pause. That seems to be. I don't know if there's anything on the reverse direction. No, there's nothing on the reverse. I don't know what's on this tape. Fast forward. That seems to be working all right. And then rewind. I like how you can go directly to rewind. I think it's smooth. That's very nice. And then go back to play. Probably shouldn't be using one small reel and one big reel. Adjust the tension for each. There's a button here for, I think it's this one of these. If we look at the faceplate, that does reel size, and it actually changes the tension of these motors. So we probably got to use the same size and then set the button appropriately. But anyway, seems to be working. Look at that. Well, that's the initial stage. Just get the thing working. Then I can do a recap and whatever else. So, that's the first step right there. I'm doing some more work on my RT909 deck. I'm trying to trace down a wow and flutter problem that I'm having with the deck. And I've actually discovered that the main issue was the capstan belt that I replaced, which was not provided by Pioneer, it was made by a third-party company, was actually too thick and was actually causing the issue. This is the belt that I took off of there, and it was actually quite a bit thicker than the original Pioneer belt that I got directly from Pioneer. So I've put that on there right now, and I'm currently doing some recording and playing back. Now, I don't have a JIS or a DIN test tape to check the wow and flutter, so what I'm doing is recording the tones and then playing them back, and knowing that that is double the amount, that gets me pretty darn close in the ballpark. I don't need the exact measurement, I'm just trying to make sure it's close to spec. So right now I'm recording and playing back, and I'm actually getting some very good measurements here. I have this new wow and flutter meter, which has been calibrated, and I'm currently set to the main wound flutter, not the weighted. I'll check the weighted in a second. This is set to the 0.1 range, which means that full scale there is 0.1. So What I'm getting is 0.025-ish. That's double, so it's actually below 0.02. And the manual states that it should be 0.04 or less. So, therefore, I'm within spec now. Even if you look at the doubled measurement, I'm still within spec. In fact, if I take it down to the 0.03 scale, I'm still on the scale, which means I'm actually doing about half of the maximum spec, which is good now. And the needle moves around a tiny bit, but it's not a big deal. So that is actually working a lot better, and I'm going to have to do some recordings and see how it sounds. But I have a feeling that that'll correct it, because I was able to hear it before, and I did take a measurement using this meter before I replaced the belt, and it was well out of spec. It was 0.15, 0.16 doubled with the recording, so it would mean 0.08, which is already double the spec. So I'm much happier with the deck now, and when you watch the capstan motor, it actually does look a bit smoother as well. So that's good. Looks nice. So now it's just a matter of getting the speed adjustments correct, which is I'm doing with some tones I've made before I took the deck apart, and getting that correct. I'm using the drift feature for that, so get that all adjusted up nicely, and hopefully I can actually start doing some other things to the deck at some point, like recapping and cleaning and other electromechanical adjustments. So what I'm working on right now, since I've got the wow and flutter issue resolved, is I'm starting to do a little bit of recapping on this thing, and the first thing I'm working on is this big board that rides here behind the real motors and controls that and a few other things, the solenoids and other stuff. I'm working on recapping this and just going through and redoing all the solder joints and cleaning it up. The board's actually in good shape. I'm not finding any other components out of spec or anything except just a few capacitors, which I'm changing. Nothing really badly shorted or open, just a few things that are a little bit out of tolerance and may have taken some heat at some point. I'm replacing all the original 85 degree Celsius capacitors with 105 degree capacitors, which should give it a little bit of extra life and heat tolerance as well. So that'll be nice. I just have a few more to finish up back here. I've even replaced this big long axial one, so that's nice. I'm just working on that right now, and I may not do it immediately, but at some point I'm going to have to go through and adjust. These are for all the different torques for the real motors in different modes, such as reverse rewind and forward rewind, reverse play, forward play, etc. Those are all the different torque setups for that, so I'll have to do those adjustments as well. I don't believe I'm going to be replacing those pots with anything multi-turn or anything like that, because I don't believe these adjustments are that sensitive, and I'll just exercise the pots a few times to make sure that they don't have any crud in them, and maybe if they really need a shot of deoxid or something, but I think I'm going to leave those. I don't see the point in spending $3 to $5 each to replace those at, how many are there, 10, I believe, just for, you know, the adjustment purposes. So that's what I'm working on right now. Get this board back in and fire it up and test to make sure everything works okay before moving on. Well, what I'm doing right now is I finished all the capacitors on this board, and what I've done is I've re-soldered meticulously every joint on the board. And what I'm doing right now is I'm cleaning off all the flux, residue, and garbage that's on this board. I've only made it over to about here, and I still got to do this section of the board. This section is clean, and all the joints are good, clean, shiny, and have been reflowed with new solder. So hopefully that's going to improve the reliability of this board. I'm planning on doing it with all the other boards as well. We'll finish cleaning up this section, and hope to do that with the rest of the boards as well, to get them to their maximum amount of reliability. What I'm doing now is a functional test after I've completed that big motor control board, just to make sure that all the proper things happen when they're supposed to. For example, you're playing in one direction and you want to switch to another direction, should stop, reverse capstan, then go in the other direction. You want to fast forward, that's fine. Stop, go. This thing has electromagnetic braking, and you can put it directly into reverse without tape spillage. It should reverse without spilling any tape. Stop has electromagnetic braking as well. The brakes on here aren't redone. I don't know if I'm going to be able to find the pads to redo them. The wheels do spin a little bit when you try and turn it. There's not a lot of force there actually braking it. But this has electromagnetic brakes, which is nice. It reverses the current on the motor to slow it down when you're fast forwarding or rewinding, so that's really neat. I'm just giving this a functional test. It had to reverse caps in there because I had it running in play previously the opposite direction. Pause and everything works. I do need to redo these tension rollers here. Watch this, when I take it in and out of pause, you get a little blurp of tape. See that little blurp? Let's see if it does it in the other direction. Yeah, you get the little blurp over there too.